I'm also curious about this. I don't know if you face this, but we were just looking at, like, there's lists there, like the least deserving Heisman winners. And I think we attach how you perform as a pro, whether or not you were worthy of the Heisman Trophy as a college player. Do you find that there people have a hard time separating the two?
My situation.
I mean, not with you, but I'm just saying that, like, Jason White at Oklahoma, Gino Toretta, like, their names always come up. Right?
It doesn't take away from what they did over those 4 years, what they did that senior year or whatever year it was they happened to win. You know, they led a team. So much is team oriented. And I say this even today. You know, we look at the greatest athletes. And they're phenomenal. It might be a tailback, might be a defensive back. But if they're not in the mix for a national championship, more so today than even back then, they're not even considered. You've got to be almost undefeated, one loss at best, and, you know, to get in that mix. And you know, those guys that didn't have successful pro careers, they led their teams. They did what was necessary under the circumstances and, set themselves apart. So, I have no problem with that. You know, there's certain guys that didn't play at all. And, you know, it just, those things happen. Sometimes, you know, there is something to be said for the scheme. You know, certain quarterbacks get in the scheme. They're throwing all these wide receiver screens and they get 10,000 yards passing.
Yeah.
You know? So, there are some parts of it that are skewed. But for the most part, you're picking guys that have had tremendous years and led their teams to, whether it's a national championship or not, in the mix.
I'm also curious what you think. Like, if you were at Boston College and you were winning the Heisman Trophy this year, how different would it be, you know, how teams would look at you as a professional quarterback?
Oh, yeah, it's night and day now. With all the spread offenses and the undersized quarterbacks that are having success. And, I'm very jealous of the game today. A lot of the stuff that's going on right now in the NFL is stuff we did in Canada for those 8 years I was up in Canada. Complete spread offenses, quarterback design runs, quarterback zone read type stuff with run pass options off. We were doing all that stuff in the 90s up in Canada. And I get a little jealous of that.
But
no doubt.
What were you, 11th round draft pick?
I was an 11th round draft pick because I'd already signed. I was projected anywhere from a first to a fourth.
Oh.
And I signed with the New Jersey Generals, Donald Trump, and I was under contract for 6 years. So just towards the end of the draft, as it was coming around, the Rams picked up my rights. But I was still under contract for another 4 or 5 years in the USFL. When the USFL folded, then the Rams had already drafted Jim Everett the next year, traded my rights over to Chicago, and I went to Chicago.
For more Dan Patrick Show, tune into Audience Channel 239 on DirecTV, stream for free on BR Live, or download the Dan Patrick Show app.